Some of the main challenges that we see involving corporate governance is that over the last few decades, we've had a variety of incidents of bad corporate behavior that had significant impacts in particular industries, like the Enron scandals of the early 2000s, all the way leading to the scandals in the financial industry and the bad decisions made in the financial industry that led to the recession in 2008 and 2009. And so the challenges are, how do we address those problems by putting in place a system of controls and checks and balances on the people that are running these companies to allow the shareholders to have a greater voice, to make sure that regulatory bodies are in place in governments to oversee the behavior of corporate upper-level management, and to oversee the reporting of the financial records, see their transparency is the order of the day. How do we balance that without handcuffing them so much that they can't do their job effectively? And so that's what I see as the greatest challenge, is we want to give shareholders a greater voice. We want corporate managers, specifically directors and officers that are running these companies, to be more accountable. And we want government to have a legitimate oversight to make sure that extreme bad behavior does not take place again. But at the same time, these are the individuals taking the risks to be the leaders of these companies, to innovate and create opportunities for people to have jobs, for new products and new services, new cures for diseases. I mean, you've got to give a certain leeway to the individuals that run these companies to do their job well. So it's a balancing act. And what I think you see is you see governments grappling with being providing oversight without being intrusive, and that political process is not perfect, but it has been working reasonably well. Some countries or some regions, like the European Union, perhaps has gone further than other places have, like the United States. But time will tell what degree of oversight, what degree of regulatory controls we need to have in place. But you have to carefully balance that so that business people can do their job.